Welcome to this lesson, ladies and gentlemen of tomorrow. It's P6 English. Our topic is using a dictionary, and we are looking at term 3 work. By the way, it's the last topic of term 3. Hotels, done, understood. It's now a discussion about using a dictionary. And under this subtopic of, under this topic of using a dictionary, we are looking at something to do with abbreviations. Yes, you know dictionaries and abbreviations are inseparable. In other words, you cannot separate abbreviations from a dictionary. If you do so, then you will have taken out a very huge quantity of work that is shown in our dictionaries. So, let's look at abbreviations today. And we're saying an abbreviation, by definition, is the short form of a word. Simple as that. An abbreviation is the short form of a word. And we're saying some abbreviations have non-English origins. Yes, we have abbreviations that were not originally English words. Or they were not in the English language according to history. However, English is formed from words from different languages. Yes, you get a word from Luganda, Matoke, you take it and it becomes part of the English language. It's now in your dictionary. You get a word like boda boda from East Africa, Kenya or Tanzania, Zanzibar, you take it and it becomes part of your dictionary. So, you see all such words in the English dictionary. You go to French. French is a language spoken in France. You borrow words like chef. When you take them, they become part of the English language. So there are some abbreviations that were borrowed from other languages. And we are saying for such abbreviations, the full form should always be written in English. In other words, they have English meanings, and those meanings are the ones we want you to write when we ask you to write those abbreviations in full. So, in fact, our list begins with such abbreviations. Some of them are sampled here. The rest have been left out because, like I normally tell you, we can't write everything we want you to learn on the board. Otherwise, we may end up teaching one stuff in a week. So, we have the abbreviation here, which is also written in short form. Then the full form this side. Follow and learn something. When you look at AM came from a different language, not English. Originally, it was a Latin abbreviation. When it joined English, we just coined its meaning from the Latin, the translation of antemeridium, which is Latin, translated to English becomes in the morning. So this is the answer we want, because if you write Latin, teachers will tell you, for us we teach English, we don't teach Latin, so we want your answer in English, which is in the morning, not any other answer you think of. Then PM, PM, if AM is in the morning, what about PM? That is in the afternoon. In Latin, it is post meridiem. In the afternoon. One can also say in the evening. In the afternoon of evening. Either can work depending on the time of the day. If I write like this, 6:00 p.m., this is 6 o'clock in the evening. If I write 5:00 p.m., this is 5 o'clock in the afternoon. So be careful. Evening time starts at 6. Then afternoon time ends at this time, 5:59 p.m. That's when afternoon time ends. So don't meet a teacher at this time and greet him good evening. Don't meet a teacher at this time and greet him good afternoon. Never like that. Okay, let's leave that aside. We've mastered when to say good evening and when to say good afternoon. V or VS. Originally in Latin, yes, Latin also. This one originally meant versus, but the Englishmen and women
or the abbreviation as well as the full form. So if I write my answer versus, it is correct because versus nowadays an English word, which means against. Then viz, videvisit in Latin changes to namely in English, namely. Next, RSVP. This one is from French. It was borrowed from the language known as French. At the beginning I told you, French is the language spoken in a country known as France. So the British or the Englishmen went across the border to France and they borrowed this abbreviation, RSVP, répondez s'il vous plaît, which changes to please reply, using letters. Please reply. Check. Here the short form is given in capital letters, then the answer for the full form is given in small letters. Next is AD, originally Latin, meaning Anno Domini. Okay, the full form of AD in Latin is Anno Domini. Change it to English, in the year. In the year of, it's like a sentence almost. In the year of our Lord. Some people say in the year of the Lord, which is also okay. Then MB, yeah, is also a Latin abbreviation, meaning, okay, in Latin, you take nota bene. Nota bene, then in English, means not well. Not well. The Vagand also use it, NB. And for them, they have also coined their meaning of NB. Nevino Vikun, that is in Uganda. But in English, not well. Then Latin, nota bene. Yeah, three different languages in one lesson. EG. That is exempli gratia in Latin. Change to English becomes for example. Where we've used the full stops, please maintain them. For example, ETC. ETC, full stop. That is etc. It's nowadays an English word, but we prefer the full form which is in English. And that is and so. On. Be careful not to write and soon. That is, if you join these words. And so on. There are three words used as the full form of ETC. Our next word is RSVP. This is an English word, an English abbreviation, and that changes to Reverend. Master the spelling of Reverend. There's no letter A in our answer. Reverend. R-A-V-E-R-E-N-D. Then P, as taught in P5. P has no identification number. Identification number. Space. Okay. Hope it is clear there. Has no. My letters A, A are not very clear. Just try to make them clearer. Has no identification number. That is PIN. Next is CF or CP. This abbreviation is used to mean compare. Small c, compare. Then MC. And MC here means master of ceremonies. Master of ceremonies. Not ceremony, but ceremonies in plural. PSV. Yeah. This brand is used on vehicles. PSV, that's for the public. P stands for public. And that is public service. Vehicle. Like the taxis you use are known as public service vehicles, therefore serving the entire public, all people in general. Next is DOZ, and that is DOZ. Then VOL, which changes to volume. On your radio, you will find such. On your remote, you will find such. DOZ. VOL, that is volume. R.I.P. used normally on gravestones or condolence messages and means rest in peace. Rest in peace. Yes. Do not add the word eternal. Nowadays some people spoil it. Why do I say they spoil it? Because you find someone, for example, you are, let's say, using WhatsApp to tell your friend, oh, I've lost someone, I've lost a loved one of this name, and he has been living in this village. Oh, sorry. Then they respond like this. Others type this. To them, it means may he so rest in peace, and we don't have that in our English. To them, it means may he so rest in eternal peace. We don't have these abbreviations in English. They are not written, they're just coined by WhatsApp users. So avoid using them. Our abbreviation we know about rest in peace is R.I.P. RIP, but written in capitals. Then the full form, strictly small letters, not full stop. Not full stop. Lastly, SOS. That is save our souls. Save our souls. I do not have all abbreviations here. Meaning, you are going to use your dictionary to get mind my abbreviations. Yes, and complete those gaps as you see them in the workbook on those pages. Which pages? 51, yes, page 51, 52, 53, yeah, and 54, by the way. All those abbreviations are supposed to be answered by you, not the teacher. Use your dictionary, do not forget to use your dictionary to get the exact abbreviations and the full forms as shown there. Let's look at question tags right now. Question tags. What does the teacher have to tell us about question tags? You see, question tags are short questions used at the end of positive or affirmative statements. If there is an affirmative statement or a negative one, you can create a question tag for that one. And that question tag is in the form of a question, usually short. When do we use question tags? We use them to ask. Okay, speakers use question tags to ask listeners to agree with them. Speakers use question tags to ask listeners to agree with them. There's a pastor or reverend or any other religious leader preaching in church, and he says, Jesus was a humble man. Wasn't he? He's using the question tag, wasn't he? Asking the congregation or the believers to agree with his suggestion or his statement that Jesus was a humble man. So, you use question tags to ask the listener to agree with you. That's the general we can use question tags. And the same question tags are formed using helping verbs and pronouns. We use auxiliary verbs or helping verbs and pronouns. In fact, it's a combination of helping verbs and pronouns. There's no question tag you're going to form without a helping verb. There's no question tag you're going to form without a pronoun, unless you want to create comment, and obvious people will laugh, including your friends. But if you are not targeting that, then your question tag must have a helping verb and its pronoun. Then affirmative sentences take negative question tags, and vice versa. And the reverse is true. And what's the reverse? The reverse is negative sentences take affirmative question tags. The word affirmative is the same as positive. Some of you were taught the word positive, not affirmative, in those lower classes. So, let's look at the examples of sentences that require us to add question tags at the end. Peter is a tall boy. This sentence is affirmative. How do I get its question tag? I'm supposed to use a negative question tag. Because the sentence is affirmative or positive, I use a negative question tag. When I use a negative question tag, I'm going to use the contracted form of the in the question tag meaning, we use the contraction, but not the full form. The contraction is this. Then the full form is not. So this versus this, you use the contraction and you leave the full form in your question tag. So our question tag will be isn't. I am done with the helping verb is plus it's not, which is contracted. Then Peter, change Peter, which is a noun, to a pronoun. What's the pronoun for Peter? Should be he, because Peter is a boy. Isn't he? Remember to put a question mark at the end so that your teacher doesn't find in trouble when you answer. So Peter is a tall boy, isn't he? Then the other way around. The sentence is negative. Now, which question tag do I use? Peter is not a tall boy. Is he? Remember to put a question mark at the end because you're asking the listener to agree with you. In other words, it is a short question as we agreed at the beginning of the subtopic. So we say, Peter is not a tall boy. Is he? Peter is a tall boy. Is he? NB. We say NB means not well. What are supposed to not well under question tags? For sentences without helping verbs, yes, these ones have helping verbs, but now we are going to be given a sentence that has no helping verb at all. What do you do? You are supposed to use the suitable form of verb to do to form the question tags. I've given you a sentence and you've discovered the sentence has no helping verb. What do I do? I don't need to count sheets or lights in the room. I have to use or to choose the suitable form of verb to do to complete my sentence with the right to question tag. Myra eats mangoes. This is not a helping verb, this is a main verb, meaning our sentence has no helping verb. But the teacher said we are meant to form question tags using helping verbs. So I get my helping verb from verb to do. And that helping verb must suit this tense. Which tense is this? The simple present or the present simple tense. So what's my question tag? If Mira or Myra eats mangoes, it means my question tag will be doesn't. Because my verb here is eats, which is present simple. I form my question tag in the present simple. Doesn't she? Question tag. I mean question mark at the end. NB. A question mark comes after comma. I mean a question tag comes after comma and that question tag begins with a small letter. I emphasize this. Question tags come after commas. Question tags begin with small letters. Question tags end with question marks. So we have Myra eats mangoes. That's the shape. The mother woke up early. What's the suitable form of verb to do that can be used to form the question tag in this sentence? You look at the tense. When you look at the tense in this question, you discover that the question is in the past. Since it is in the past, we are going to use did. And this sentence is in the past and is affirmative. So we use did because we need a negative question tag. Did she? And that's our answer. Mother woke up early. Did she? In other words, did she wake up early? So that's all I can say about question tags connected to those sentences and examples you will see. Let's now turn to the workbook and we summarize our lesson on page 57. Turn to page 57, listen and follow. We have special forms of question tags as shown in the workbook. Special forms of question tags as you see them on page 57. We are saying, let's talk about I am. Let's, and we call it a day. I am uses the question tag and I. Not aren't, but and I. So if I say, I am sick, and I am not sick, that one requires a different question tag. When the statement is positive, am I? Okay, let's repeat afresh. We are saying, it uses the tag and I when the sentence is positive and am I when the sentence is negative.
So if I say, if I mention, if I make, let's say, a negative sentence, you expect the question tag to be, am I? I am not tall. Am I? Then the sentence is affirmative. I am tall. And I don't use the other version which you may think about. I cannot mention it here. You laugh and laugh and laugh. You laugh your head off. Okay, examples. You have, I am a teacher. And I. Then I am not a teacher, which is negative. Am I? Being a question tag. C. I am in P6 this year. And I. Then lastly, D. I am not going there. Am I? That's our question tag. Then let's. Let's. The question tag for let's is always shall we. Let's is a suggestion. But let us, or let me, or let them, or let her, will take, will you as the question tag. The examples are given there. Number 1 up to 4, that's A, B, C, D. Let's go to the library. A suggestion. Shall we is our question tag. Because the question begins, or the sentence begins with let's. Then let us, two separate words. Let us go to the library. Will you? In other words, this question B, someone is asking another one to give them permission to go to the library. Then in the end you ask, will you give us permission to go to the library? Or will you let us go to the library? That's the meaning in sentence 2. Sentence 3, which is C, let's have a spelling B, shall we? Then lastly, let me call you after an hour as the last example. And it's C, question tag is, will you? Do not forget to begin your question tags with small letters and to put commas and finally to punctuate with the right punctuation mark, and that is a question mark. Let's look at the question tags for imperatives or imperative sentences. And we say imperative sentences are orders, commands, or requests. They're in that category. And they usually begin with verbs. Sentences that begin with verbs take the same question tag, and that question tag is, you see it there, will you? If I say wake up, that's an order, call it a command. Wake up, will you? That's the question tag. Then do not wake up, still that's an order. In other words, I'm commanding you to sleep. Still the question tag will be, whether negative, whether affirmative, an order takes the question tag, will you? Members, I believe this should be enough for you to complete that activity on page 57 and page 58. Where you have issues, you can always contact the teacher on the number you see on the board. This number is only on WhatsApp. So contact me and we chat more about question tags and any other stuff you encounter in this workbook. The next time I join you here, or you join me here, we'll be discussing the use of this structure after and before. God bless you. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.